happened with Van Halen?
Well, I cannot stand to wake up in the morning. The reason I'm going slow here is because I can't remember the last time I got up in the morning. No, I hate waking up and not having something to do. I gotta go, man. I gotta be active, gotta accomplish something. I don't know. You know, gotta be a shining example. I'm not sure of what, you know, but we gotta go. And things were just starting to slow down with the band, you know. It was a take time, you know, take more time. I want to go in the studio for a year. The studio for a year? I can't stand the inside of the studio anyways from the beginning, you know. Mess up my tan, you know. And I says, so what's the payoff? You know, he says, yeah, it'll take about a year maybe to get in the studio, you know, make the new record. A year. Yeah, what's the payoff? Because, you know, I like to do it on two legs. You know, I want to dance. You know, I want to move around, you know, and I want to talk to you. And I'm going to come in. I'm at your back door, man. I'm inside your body just like my words are right now, man. That's where I'm coming from. And he says, yeah, well, we play stadiums. Stadiums? You can't hear my jokes in between the songs, you know. You get us some cool shoes or something. You can't see the shoes unless you have some 80X binoculars, you know, some desert rat binoculars trying to look up there. It's like the Michael Jackson show. Next. Come on, that's a hell of a payoff, buddy. You know? And then we're going to produce ourselves. The kiss of death. You know? Love Teddy Templeman. I work real well with Teddy, you know. Always have. Geez, the last album.
God, it almost took 4 days.
You know, we put preparation up for it, but 4 days' time, you know, to make the record. I got to step aside from it, guys, you know. I got to step aside from it. And I talked up everything, you know. Says, hey, how about if we go on the road and let's see how about a live album? We have tapes. No live album. All right, how about a live album with two new songs, one on each side like Benatar? No Benatar, no live album. Then we'll go on the road. No road. So, you know, now they've become impaled on the very thing they were fighting against. Now they have to go on the road. Now they have to stay out for a prolonged period of time, and now they have to do all that, you know, and go, you go, you know. And, you know, I'm very happy, man.
You did not leave this band, though, to go become a movie star.
That's ridiculous. No, Edward says that because he wants you to be pissed at me. He wants you to dislike me just as much as he does, you know. And he's going to come and he says, yeah, well, he wants to be a movie star. So you think of all you rock cats and kitties out there. You're going to turn around and go, yeah, Dave, he's turning into Sting. He thinks he's Dr. Frankenstein. Blah. You know, you come like that. Hey, man, you know, I'm going to make a movie. Look, after 7.5 years of a blistering neon plastic at 33 1/3, you know, go like that. Can I make a movie, one? You know, I go, and we make a movie. And it'll take me, what, how many months? And we get a beautiful new record out of it, and we'll smear the music all over the movie, and then we're going to go on tour, and we're never going to come home.
So, Dave, you're going to be a movie star.
Well, I don't know if we're going to be a movie star. I figure the flick's going to be great. You know, we wrote it, directing, acting in it, and the whole thing. And I figure it's going to be great. And if it comes out great, then, you know, Siskel and Ebert are going to get on the tube, and they're going to go, oh, bright new young star on the horizon, you know, somebody to watch for, you know, a stroke of whatever like this. And if it turns out stinky, which is always a possibility, then they'll get up there and they'll go, hey, man, who gave these schmoes $10 million to get drunk, man, and go out in the tropics and make what amounts to a home movie with a bunch of beautiful girls? And isn't that rock and roll? Anyway, they'll be on tour next Wednesday.
Now, wait a minute. Let me ask you something. First of all, they gave you $10 million. Is that what the budget is?
Yeah, well, the story is, you know, that's all included. And we wrote it. We directed it. We're the fabulous Picasso brothers. It's Pete Angelus and I. We did the videos for Van Halen and, you know, like Cowgirls and Gigolo. And we were involved in all the productions. You know, the whole idea was to, you know, test our metal as it were, you know, be able to use the manpower, be able to learn color correction, be able to edit, be able to direct the talent, and do like that, prove our stuff in that forum. And then from there, go, you know, when I go to the office of the three-piecers and everything, and I say, yes, I want to direct this, you know, like that, then I have some credence behind it.
Why do you and Pete call yourselves the Picasso brothers?
Picasso, because that is fine art. And brothers makes it sound more like pizza delivery, which is kind of where what we do comes halfway. The answer, as usual, ladies and gentlemen, is halfway in between, you know. When you get into the video area, you probably have 9, 12 different director producer teams who do all of your top 10, the top 15 videos that you see all year round, regardless of who the act is. And what happened is, just like when synthesizers and everything became really hip in the studio, then, you know, all of the technology within the video bay, you know, came into play, and they start losing the substance of the film. They start losing the theater, because you've got these guys, the video jacks, man, ramming it home with the phase shifting, you know, light reading meter, you know, and the IBM Computrex readout, digital, you know, fadeaways and everything like that. And they left theater behind, much as when they started using electronics and things in the studio, they started forgetting about melody a little bit. You stopped having so many songs and then pieces of music that are just mostly sound. A lot of disco is just a lot of sound. You don't really sing along with it, you know. And we came right back and says, we'll go right with theater and worry about the technology later. You know, we say, we'll ask a lot of questions until we learn the ropes. What do we know from editing? What did we know from color correcting? What did we know from any of that? But we said, we'll go ahead first. We went in and we said, but we'll start with the theater, because I don't know nothing else. I don't know what this button does. I don't know what this stick does. I can't even adjust my watch, man. You know, that's how I am, you know. I don't understand the electronics at all. So we started with the theater, got to the faces, you know, and you know, some compassion there, some interaction between people or between the screen and the people in the living rooms. We'll speak to their children and they will take it into the homes.
You've also told me that you didn't have much time in the past to have a girlfriend. Then I know you recently did break up with somebody. That didn't work out?
When you break up with somebody that you love like that, then that's God's way of telling you it's time to go out and make $1 million and get busy.
But you used to tell... You used to tell me that you did want somebody to share your life with, and you did want a girl to take with you to the jungle, or to climb a mountain, or to go out in the middle of the night, or whatever.
It's not specifically those things. I remember when she says to me, well, how about if you go in this place or you go that place and she just stays home and then you can come home to her and like that, you know?
I said that.
Yeah. But that's not sharing. That's not sharing the experience. Then you become an audience. Then you have more of an audience. How was it? It was pouring rain. We were so, you know, and it's, that's like, you know, that's not a partner.